Are you awake? Are you wide awake? I don't want you to blink on this one. I want your full attention. Last month, national news of a child abuse case here in South Florida, to be exact, it was in West Palm Beach, Florida. There was a young boy killed by his parents, and it is obvious from the results that this had been an ongoing neglect and child abuse case by these parents. These parents adopted these two siblings, a boy and a girl. Today, the little boy is no longer with us, but the parents, fortunately, are behind bars, awaiting trial. And they both have been charged with murder, and the prosecution will be asking for the death penalty. Childhood neglect and abuse does not have a specific geographical location. It's not gender or race-based. It is not a socioeconomic status that determines child abuse. It is a worldwide issue. And I call it a silent epidemic because our children don't seem to have a voice, because we're not listening to their cries. We're not listening to their cries of abuse and neglect. I'm sure this is not a topic that you or anyone else would like to have in an everyday conversation, but it is a topic that we need to address and address immediately for our children's sake. So today, I'm going to persuade you to look at childhood and abuse prevention measures so that we can stop this epidemic and give our children a chance to live a normal life. So I'm going to ask that you take a look at this video.
A 2-year-old girl, once full of life and energy, is dead. Police say she was beaten to death by her mother's boyfriend, the alleged weapon, a video game controller.
Being a parent is a tough job. I think it is a job that both this mother and her boyfriend failed at drastically.
26-year-old Harvey Johnson now faces first-degree murder charges. Police say he admitted to beating 2-year-old Derizabel Baez with a controller, but did not say why. The girl's mother, 19-year-old Nita Baez, is also behind bars, charged with child endangerment. Police say she heard the beating Sunday afternoon, but did nothing until she realized the girl was unconscious.
This tragic moment was not a unique moment in time. There had to have been behavior between those adults and that child that were showing signs to the community that something was terribly amiss.
Police say the girl had been beaten for months. The coroner calls it one of the worst child abuse cases he's ever seen. Authorities say charges against her mother could be upgraded. There is now a makeshift memorial full of candles and teddy bears outside the family's home in York. Brian Thomas, The Associated Press.
Today, I will be sharing with you some facts from the Early Childhood Education Journal in regard to the first legal child abuse case in America in 1874. The results of the Spare the Rod for the child and the conditions surrounding it. How did the child live the rest of her life? And how did this case change the way the legal system treated children? We will look into the current opinions of the pediatrics child abuse and neglect as a worldwide epidemic. We will look at ways of prevention of child abuse and neglect, according to the Child Abuse Review. Then we will take a look at the national abuse statistics from Child Help. Now, the first legal case of child abuse reported by the Early Childhood Education Journal states that a 10-year-old girl by the name of Mary Ellen McCormick in 1874, her abuse and neglect case was successfully prosecuted, the first in America. Prior to this time, children and animals were considered property of their owners and their parents. Parents were immune to criminal prosecution during this time. Mary Ellen's father died when she was just a baby. Her mother struggled to take care of her, led her to place her in an orphanage. She was adopted later on by a couple, and the husband died, and the wife began the abuse of Mary Ellen. She was neglected, she was underfed, she was beaten, spared the rod, spoiled the child. I think not. Now, neighbors reported this because they noticed the continued abuse of this child. And they reported it to an organization called Public Charities and Corrections. Now, Mary Ellen's caseworker contacted the American Society of the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals because there were no laws drafted up for children. But ironically, there were laws to prevent cruelty to animals. Henry Burr, the founder of the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, saw Mary Ellen as a vulnerable member of the animal kingdom and needed protection of the state. Mary Ellen was later adopted by her caseworker. Mary Ellen got married later on. She had two children of her own. She inherited two children from her husband, and she paid it forward. She adopted an orphan and raised her and was an excellent mother. She lived to be 92 years old, and she died in 1956. The Child Review gave us some preventive measures on child abuse and neglect and some statistical facts. Programs such as teach children personal safety, knowledge and skills on child sexual abuse. Programs that involve parents. The more knowledge that parents have, the likelihood they can create a safer environment for their children. Now, childhood sexual abuse is a significant public health problem. It states that 1 in 5 women and 1 in 12 men report suffering from sexual abuse before the age of 18. Now, the current opinion in pediatrics states many forms of child abuse continue to grow. However, there is controversy here, centered around the diagnosis of various types of abuse. To give you an example, abusive head injuries. And there's some controversy there because it could be caused by a vitamin D deficiency. So a lot of times these abuses or misdiagnoses or some controversies there because it might not have really been a physical abuse from a parent or a caretaker, but because there was truly a vitamin deficiency that caused the injury to the head. Now here I'm going to give you some general statistics about child abuse that was released through Child Help in 2007. A report of a child abuse is made every 10 seconds. Almost 5 children die every day as a result of child abuse. More than 3 out of 4 are under the age of 4, totally helpless. It is estimated that between 60 to 85% of child fatalities are due to maltreatment, are not recorded as such on death certificates. So the treatment that led up to the child's death is never recorded on the death certificates. Why did it take so long to address neglect and abuse, childhood abuse problems? Why has it taken so long to address it? Where children look upon us non-important or part of the status quo, are they not important to us? They get married, have children, issues arise such as job situations or loss, marital problems, substance abuse, and socioeconomic conditions. It is not okay to take your frustration out on children. And in 1874, a young girl by the name of Mary Ellen McCormick, neglected and abused, case was successfully prosecuted in America. That was 137 years ago, and we are still fighting this battle of child neglect and abuse. Hello? Hello? Is anybody listening? I put the challenge to you today. Become educated on child abuse and neglect and abuse, and do not be silent.